will start the new chapter, that is chapter 2, Early Humans. According to scientists, life began on Earth some 3,500 million years ago. Subsequently, human beings developed in stages over millions of years till they reached the most advanced stage of development. So, according to scientists, our life began on Earth around 3,500 million years ago, and slowly and gradually the human beings started developing in stages. The modern human, that is Homo sapiens, represent the most advanced stage in the process of development called evolution. So the modern human, which is also known as Homo sapiens, it is the most advanced stage in the process of development, and it is called evolution. Modern humans probably evolved between 2 lakhs and 1 lakh years ago. So the modern period, or the modern humans, they have evolved between 2 lakhs and 1 lakh years ago. In the initial stages of development, humans work like apes. So in the initial stage of development, humans used to work like apes, like the monkeys. Gradually, they learn to stand on their feet with a straight posture. So slowly and gradually, so in this way, first they used to crawl. Slowly and gradually, they started walking in a correct posture, which we work today. Their hands become free, which help them to hold things better. So their hands also develop, through which they can hold the things in a better way. They could pick up and throw things to defend themselves. The body structure of the earliest human beings change over time. So slowly and gradually, their body structure, they were able to pick up and throw anything. Their brain became larger, while the jaws and tooth got reduced in size. So their brain become larger, and their jaws and teeth were reduced in size. They learned to adapt themselves to their surroundings. So slowly and gradually, they started adapting in their surrounding. In this process, they learned to use stone to kill the prey. So with the help of stone, they used to kill the animals for crushing nuts and so on. They realized that sharp edge of broken stones were very useful for cutting woods and spiking animals. So they have realized that in order to cut any wood, or in order to harm any animals, they required sharp broken stones. Further, they learned to use stones for making tools and weapons according to their needs. So slowly and gradually, they started using different types of stone for making tools and weapons. Next is Stone Age. The prehistoric age is also known as Stone Age because stone were used on a large scale. So why the prehistoric age is known as Stone Age? Because huge amount of stones were used during prehistoric age. It is divided into 4 periods. So the prehistoric, or the Stone Age, is divided into 4 parts. So the different parts are Paleolithic, Mesolithic, Neolithic and Chalcolithic. Paleolithic, around 2 lakhs to 12,000 years ago. Mesolithic, around 12,000 to 10,000 years ago. Neolithic, around 6,000 to 4,000 years ago. And Chalcolithic, around 4,000 to 1,700 years ago. So this is an indicative timeline of the Stone Age. The word Paleolithic has come from the 2 Greek words. So first is Paleo, and the other word is Lithos. So the Paleo means old, and the Lithos means stone. The name itself shows the importance of stone tools and implement. These periods started around 2 million years ago and ended in about 12,000 years ago. Certain environmental changes started taking place about 12,000 years ago. So when the different types of ages had taken place, or you can say when the Paleolithic started, there was a certain changes in their lifestyle. This marked the beginning of the Mesolithic age, or middle stone age. So after Paleolithic, the Mesolithic age, or the middle age, started to evolve. It was followed by the Neolithic and the Chalcolithic ages, which were far more advanced than the preceding ages in terms of technology and methods of tool making, as well as different aspects of life. We shall read about them in the next chapter. So now, slowly and gradually, the society was changing. First we will learn about Paleolithic, then we will learn about Mesolithic, then Neolithic and Chalcolithic.